Hey everyone, so today's video is going to be about Top Gear, and as well as just talking about the show in general, I will also talk about how the Stig's identity has been revealed, obviously there's a big uproar about that, but more on that in a bit. Now if you said to me, there's a show about cars, you're gonna love it, I'd be like, shut up. I'm not a car person, I have no intention of driving, I'm scared of driving, I've never been behind the wheel of a car. I don't really care for big swanky cars. I don't really, I don't get obsessed over cars. I don't get excited by cars apart from the Renault Clio, but I've always loved Clios. And I just, cars are cars. They're there to get you from A to B. They're unhealthy, they're costly, and they're just, well, they're not pointless, but they're pointless if you don't need one. Like, some households have like four cars, and it's like, what's the point? Buy a pair of trainers, go walking instead. But obviously some people are really passionate about them, as with the presenters of this show. And I don't think that's a bad thing, because I think as long as you're really passionate about it, that's fine. Like, I know little kids love cars. My brother, he's 8 and he loves cars. He it's really cute because he talks about, like, he says the horsepower of this car is, and then he'll rattle off a number. And then I'll go, Perry, what's horsepower? And he'll be like, I don't know. And I mean, I've got no idea what horsepower is either, but it's beyond the point. But when the first time I watched Top Gear, I was like, I'll give it the benefit of the doubt, because I might like it. And I mean, we're talking 3, 4 years ago now. The show's been on since 2002, it's still going on, and there's just under 130 episodes, I think. And the first time I watched it, I was like, wow, I'm impressed. It just goes to show that you can't really knock something until you've tried it, because I fell in love with it straight away. I'll admit it's not one of my favorite TV shows. It's not in my list on my channel of my favorite shows. I don't get, I don't go insane if I miss it. I haven't seen all the episodes. I don't know what episodes are from what series. I don't look that much into it. But when it's on, I will sit down and watch it because I think it is just brilliant. The presenters, of course, really do make it what it is. Jeremy Clarkson, Richard Hammond, and James May. James May, first of all, is just there for me. I don't really know that much about him. I don't know about his background. I don't really engage with him that much. It's the other two that I think are quite special. Obviously, Richard Hammond used to be gorgeous, but now he's got long hair and I don't like that. No offense to Richard Hammond. Is it the Sainsbury's advert he does or the Morrisons ones? I never remember, but anyway, I don't like it. The one where he's like, he's got the shopping trolley and he's pushing it up a hill and his hair's long and it's soaking and I don't like it. But anyway, I think he is fantastic, and Jeremy Clarkson, of course, is brilliant. A lot of people say bad things about Jeremy, like especially on the comedy panel shows. Like, I'm not going to name them because that's unfair, but they always say really horrible things about him. And it's like, well, I really like him. I think it's fantastic, So Jeremy Clarkson, Richard Hammond, and James May, brilliant. I think there also used to be a different presenter in 2002. For the first series, I think James May came in the second series, but if that's the case, I've never ever seen one from series one then, so that's kind of something I'm gonna look out for. The show, the executive producer is Andy, now it's either Willman or Wildman, I'm not too sure. And I had a look on Wikipedia and things, and they seem to work with a lot of Jeremy Clarkson's shows. Obviously the Jeremy Clarkson Goes to France and whatever, and all those ones, but obviously none of them are as good as Top Gear. So basically it is about cars, but it's more entertaining than that. They don't just say, this is a car, it does this, it looks like this, compared to this, it's rubbish, There are certain parts like that where they will just look at a car and examine it, and then one of them will take it out for a test drive and compare it to another car and things. But you also have like challenges. For example, they try and lift up a car, they make over a car, they do things with caravans, and they have races and things. And it's just really wacky and outrageous and entertaining, which I think is part of the reason why children love it, because it's not just factual, you're not just getting figures and numbers and statistics and data thrown at you. It is entertaining, there is a lot going on, and it's quite enthralling for a car show. I mean, I've watched Fifth Gear, which is sort of like the credit crunch version of Top Gear. I don't like Fifth Gear. I don't know whether it's because I can't engage with the presenters or anything like that, but Top Gear is definitely a cut above everything. Now, the thing that makes it perfect for me is you always have a celebrity each week, or sometimes a couple of celebrities. I think there are a few episodes where there are no celebrities, but generally speaking, you have celebrities. Now, if you go onto Wikipedia, there is a full episode list and there's a full list of celebrities. So just to sort of give you a feel of the sort of types of celebrities that go on it and the personalities you'll find, I've written down a list of 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 that sort of caught my attention, some of which I've seen. So I've got Alan Davies, which I've not seen the one with Alan Davies, so I'm hoping it'll be on YouTube or something like that. Simon Cowell, which I've seen, although I think he's been on twice, and I've only seen one, but I love Simon Cowell. Christopher Eccleston, who is gorgeous. Joanna Lumley, I think Boris Johnson's been on it. David Tennant, of course, that's one of the best. And Billy Piper. Billy's one is my favourite because, you know, I adore Billy. And also Peter Jones and Theo Epaphitis from Dragon's Den. So you definitely get a mixed bag of personalities. So Michael Gambon's been on it. You know, they've now got Gambon Corner on the racetrack that the celebrities do, because each of the celebrities go in a car and they go around the racetrack and see who can get the fastest lap, and then whoever gets the fastest goes to the top of the leaderboard and so on. I would be terrified to do that. You know, if somebody said to me, "Amy, we're opening it up to the public, do you want to go and do this?" No. Have you seen how fast they go? It's to watch, it's alright, but I'm still sitting there. Obviously, you know that nothing bad's gonna happen to the celebrities, because if something happened, like say they crashed and, you know, got injured, you'd have heard about it before the show aired. But you're still sitting there thinking, "Oh my God, what's gonna happen? Slow down, calm down, it's not a race," even though it is a race, but you know, it's just really horrible to watch. But it's entertaining to watch, don't get me wrong. When interviewing the celebrities and looking back at their lap and things, they sit in like chairs. And this is also the same area where they sometimes bring in a car and examine it there. And then you have like a little fleet of people, like a little audience just standing up around them. Sometimes they interact with them and things. And that's really nice, because it's not like your normal sit-down audience. It makes it less formal, and it's just, I mean, it looks kind of cramped. It looks like a bit like a sheep pen where everybody's gathering around. But I really like the format there where they're just standing rather than sitting. It must tear their legs out, but I do like it. Now there is an awful lot of merchandise for Top Gear. There's so many books, there's DVDs, you know, there's advent calendars and things at Christmas. There's Top Trumps cards, which I think my brother has. Then you have all the additions, like you've got Jeremy Clarkson's things and Richard Hammond's things. And there's just so much for you to buy. So if you're going to become obsessed with this, be careful. For example, I didn't know I was going to become obsessed with Doctor Who, but from the first episode, I knew it was, you know, it was something special. And I've spent so much money on Doctor Who merchandise that I shouldn't be spending. So when you're ever going to watch a new show that's got merchandise attached to it, you do run the risk. You know, you watch the first episode, you think, it's a bit exciting. Watch episode 2, maybe 3, 4 episodes down the line, you think, I'll just buy a book. You buy a book and you think, well, I've got one, I might as well buy the whole collection of this type of book. So you go and buy maybe the fact file books, and then you think, well, I'll try an annual, and then you get this year's annual, and then the next thing you know, you're on eBay trying to backtrack all the annuals and collect them all, and then you've got Top Trumps and toys and things you don't even want. So it is very dangerous to watch a new TV show with merchandise with it, but it is worth it, so give it a go. And if you become obsessed, so be it. It's just something we're all going to have to live with when we fall in love with a new TV show like this. And also, you can go on the website topgear.com and check out everything on there as well, because there's loads of information and bits and pieces and facts and everything on there. It is a BBC show, but it's often on Deja Vu. I'm not sure when there's going to be a new episode on, because I couldn't find that information anywhere. But if you let me know, if anybody does know, I will annotate it here or something. Feels like I'm doing a 60s dance. But yeah, that's all I wanted to say. But no, that's not all I wanted to say. Gosh, I can't believe I nearly forgot this. The Stig. Yes, I'm about to say who his identity is. Obviously, I'm not revealing it for the first time. It has been a big public announcement. But if you have tried to avoid this information, you know, say you don't want to know because you think it'll spoil it, go away now. Don't worry, there's nothing else important in this video. All I'm going to talk about is the Stig, and then that's it. So he is, and I'm going to announce this. It is Ben Collins. Yeah. Who? I had no idea who that was. all the papers and online and everything are like, the Stig is Ben Collins. And I'm like, well, it doesn't really give me any more information because I still don't know who the hell it is. It's only a name, you know? It's just like, you know, it could be called anything. He's apparently some race driver, which is, you know, it makes sense. But I've got no idea who he is. So he could just be any Tom, Dick and Harry, and I've got no idea. In a sense, I'm a bit annoyed that his identity has been revealed, because what it was, there was a book published revealing the identity, and BBC took the publishers or the writer or whatever to court, and they lost the battle, so the book was published and the identity was revealed. So everybody now knows who it is, even though there was this whole big thing about the mystery of the Stig and nobody really knowing who was under the costume and under the helmet. And now we know. And to be honest, I don't think anybody cares. Because, first of all, nobody really knows who he is. Obviously, Ben Collins must be quite happy now, because I'm imagining he's going to get microphones shoved in his face left, right and centre. But generally, he's still quite mysterious. We don't really know much about him still. Maybe they'll replace the Stig, or maybe they're going to wipe the idea of the Stig out completely. But either way, I hope they make the right decision, and I hope they just don't make a mountain out of a molehill. It's really not that big a deal. But yeah, that's all I want to say now. So feel free to leave comments and things. Any requests for TV shows as usual, let me know and I will do them for you. But until next time, I will see you later. Bye guys.